going on, people? Garrett here at SCC. I hope you enjoyed that last video. Finally got some editing skills going on. Nothing too crazy, but definitely makes the video go a little smoother, having a little bit of editing in there. So definitely stoked on that. But big thing I just picked up the other day, the fuel cell from the Navigator back here. And yeah, check it out. Almost looks like a little mini coffin. It's a 23-gallon aluminum fuel cell. I built a model, like I told you guys, to send to Sick Fabrication, and man, they pretty much built it spot on. That when I got there, they had the model sitting next to it, and it looked exactly like it. So, pretty stoked on it. Fits up in there pretty nice. You got a sending unit right here. This is the out to the motor. And he actually ran a tube down to the bottom of the tank so that when the truck's hitting like Cali style or sitting straight or whatever, there's always going to be fuel hitting the motor and doesn't sputter out and stall out. And then on the front end here, so this is the back side of the tank. And then the front side, this is going to be the filler. Now you may be wondering where the hell the filler is going to be on the front. Haven't really told anyone this, it's been kind of a secret. But now that I'm actually installing it, it's time to start throwing it out there. The new filler is going to be where the wiper blades used to go. So it's going to be about right here. And I'm going to plumb it. And I'll show you on the inside of the truck. So it's going to go down behind the... It's going to be behind the brake booster. And then it's going to go down into the floor right there. And that's where that spout goes up. So that's going to be a pretty trick install. Going to get started on that pretty shortly here. Also got the rear floor pretty much patched up all the way across. The floor's pretty much done all the way through. Just got a little more welding to do right in there, but that ain't nothing. And then also got the shock tower caps. Oops. Got the shock tower caps welded in. So they turned out clean. Had to make sure that I could get my shock, the bolts that hold my shocks in, off before I welded those in. But there's plenty of clearance in there, so that's good to go. And just gonna be tackling that gas tank. Oh yeah, and then I also got another little puzzle to figure out. So since I swapped this to a rack and pinion, I was telling you guys I had to get some parts to link up the rack and pinion to the steering wheel. Bring the light over here. Yeah, so you got that hole in the exhaust right there, and as you can see, it's real close to my steering coming down. So I gotta take that piece. There it is. I gotta take that piece, basically cut it right here and make it shorter so it just goes straight from here all the way up to there. And right now it kind of flares out, so I need to go from here just straight up to there so my steering will clear. So I just stopped and got a scrap piece that I'm gonna make work on there. They don't really sell these parts. It's pretty much off of the motor and is one of a kind, so what a surprise. Gotta fabricate that. But gonna be doing these installs this week. Try to get a lot of stuff done. And I'll show you guys what's up on the Blazer as well. So stay tuned and thanks for watching. All right, late.